Hi students, welcome. In today's class we are discussing about epicycloids. So in previous class we are completed normal cycloids. So today epicycloid. So you know that cycloids, epicycloids, hypocycloids and tricyclides, these are some special curves in engineering drawing curves. Okay. So here you know that cycloid means your rolling wheel rolls on a straight line. But now here epicycloid means your rolling wheel rolls on the another wheel. You know that the rolling wheel is nothing but generating wheel. So that wheel, when the wheel is rotates, okay, the curve will be generated. So that is called generating wheel. But the generating wheel, if you want rolls without slip, means we need some guide wheels. It's nothing but directing wheel. Clear? So therefore your rolling wheel rolls on the directing wheel. It's nothing but epicycloids. Clear? So we go for how to draw epicycloids and how to draw a tangent normal for that same. Clear? So let us consider a rolling wheel of dia 60 mm. It rolls on the another wheel of dia 180 mm. Just dimensions assume it. So the rolling wheel size is 60 diameter. It rolls on the another wheel diameter is 180 diameter. Clear? So draw the curve. It's nothing but a rolling wheel rolls on. Just you understand. On is nothing but on that outside. So therefore it is the curve generated AP only. Clear? That's why. So we go for one by one. So let us assume a rolling wheel dia, let us consider 60 mm, and directing wheel dia 180 mm. A rolling wheel rolls on the another wheel. Just imagine. So this is 180 mm diameter wheel. So this is the rolling wheel dia 60. A rolling wheel rolls on the another wheel. Clear? That's one. So it form, it generates one curve. So this curve name is called epicycloidal curve. Clear? Right. We go for step by step procedure. Clear? So first you draw one inclined center line at any angle. Okay, not only incline, even you draw vertical or horizontal, whatever it may be, just okay. So we select one point, let us consider that is O. So O as a center, you draw a 180 mm diameter, that is called directing wheel. Clear? So dia 180 means radius 90, you draw 90 mm radius, you draw one circle. But actually, so in problem simply they mention draw a epicycloidal curve of size, given size. Okay, so specifically they mention two revolutions or three revolutions means you go for that curve, the 180 diameter curve, it is want to draw completely or otherwise partially. Clear? So here without mention that conditions, just assume it, it is only one revolution. Clear? That is one complete revolution. Right? So just you draw one arc of size, given diameter 180, so take radius 90. Clear? And before that you want to determine that angle, how much angle. So the theta value is nothing but small r divided by caps r into 360. So r is rolling wheel diameter, this is small r, it is directing wheel size, therefore r is rolling wheel radius, how much, 60 mm diameter means 30 mm, divided by caps r means directing wheel size is 180 mm means radius is 90, so into 360, so we get 120. So this is the theta. So therefore from here this angle, initially you are taken one, so from that point you draw one more, the size is 120 degree. So place the protractor, so 0 90 120, so this much size. So no need of too long, because so in problem the conditions, any conditions that are not given means let us consider it is a clockwise rotation and also one complete revolutions. Clear? And one more point is the starting point P, let us consider where the two wheels are intersecting or joining together, so that is the starting point P. Clear? So now you draw arc of radius 90 or that angle is 120. Okay, next thing, So from this point, the rolling wheel size is 60 mm, that is diameter, therefore radius is 30. So from here to here, 30 size this one. So let us consider that is one, you draw one circle. So the circle size is dia 60, this arc size is radius 90. Okay, after completion of this, so this is center, directing wheel center O1, rolling wheel center O2, clear. After that, the circle divided into n equal parts, clear. So better we go for the n number of equal parts, let us consider 8 equal parts. Okay, so 8 equal parts means you know well 45 degrees. So place the protractor or otherwise by using 45 degree set square. Okay, keep it. So 45 you dot or otherwise place that minute after scale, coins around it. So this edge is 45 degree, therefore you draw here 45 degree. Same here also, you draw this side also 45, no, like this. Clear, 45 degree. So total how many equal parts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 equal parts. So let us consider the starting point intersection of two, that is considered P. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. After that, you take compass, you take radius of O1 to 1 as the radius, O1 to 1 as the radius, you draw one arc, that arc, okay, O1 to 1, that arc is passing through number 7 also. Next, O1 to 2, like that, O1 to 3 and O1 to 4, clear. So O1 to 1 over O1 to 2. That one is definitely is passing through number 6. Clear? Next, O1 to 3. O1 to 3 as the radius. That curve is passing through number 5. Next, O1 to 4, and apart that one, and additionally O1 to O2 also it is considered as a one radius. So O1 to O2, so O1 to here 90 size plus 30, so 120. So here O1 as the center, O1 to O2 as the radius, it is from center, therefore that curve let us consider in center line method. It is nothing but locus of center. Clear? That's all. Clear? Next, we go for that 120 degree divided into same n number of equal parts. How many equal parts are there? The circle divided into how many you are taken, same numbers you want to take. But here, you are taken 8. Therefore, 120 degree divided by 8 equal parts. We get some degree. Okay. So how to exact fraction you want to split means it is very difficult by using that protractor. Better we go for divide an angle into 2 power n equal parts. For example, 2 power 3 is equal to 8, no? So it is suitable. Already you know that how to divide and give an angle into 2 power n equal parts. Very simple. Clear? So based on procedure, you take some x radius from O1 as a center, you draw one arc. Let us consider this is 1 and 2. From 1 as a radius, you take some x radius, you draw an arc. Same radius from 2, clear. We get the intersection. So here, you draw that. Clear. So this one. So now we bisect. Completed. Next, let us assume this is the given angle. Again, you want to bisect. Same procedure you follow, we get here. Up to center is enough. Okay. Next, this angle also bisect here. Next, let us consider this is that given angle. Okay. So this one, same procedure, you bisect. Clear? Again, this. So now we get 8 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 equal parts we get. So now you start the construction of curve finally. Okay. So let us consider this is O1 to O2. It is center. Next, this is center 1. It is initial. It is 1. It is center 2. Center 3. This one is center 4. 5, 6, 7 and final center. Okay. So total 8 equal parts, 4 plus 4. Now the procedure similar to cycloids. C1 as the center. Radius how much? The rolling wheel size is 60, means radius 30. So 30 is a common radius. Now center C1. C1 as the center, 30 as the radius. Intersect arc under number C1 means so that number 1 curve intersect. Clear? So 30 as the radius, C1 as the center, intersect here. Number 1. Next is C2 as the center, same radius, C2 as the center, number 2 here. C3 as a center, intersect arc under number 3 curve here. C4 as a center, intersect arc on number 4, exactly top. So for that reasons only, that exact bisector, that angle or line is in clear. C5 here, fifth one, because third and 5. Next is C6 as the center, 2, 6. So 2, 6, so C6 as a center. Next is C7 as a center, intersect arc under number 1, 7, this one. And C8 here, exactly here. So now this is intersection point, where it is P1, this is P2, P3, this is P4, P5, P6, P7, this is P8, is nothing but P. Now you get all the locus points you want to join by free hand curve or otherwise by using French curve. Finally, you get So this is the curve for epicycloid because a rolling wheel rolls on the another wheel. Clear? So that curve is epicycloidal curve. Clear? In same problem, how to draw a tangent and normal? Clear? So for example, draw a tangent and normal at a distance the 130. If they not mention means we choose anywhere on the curve. Or specifically they mention take 130 means you take compass, draw tangent normal at a distance 130 from center of the directing wheel means. So take compass, O1 as the center, take the given size 130 or size. So you intersect arc on that curve. So let us consider this is point M. So you draw tangent and normal at exact point M. Clear? Very simple. So here the P1, P2, P3 points. So where we get the particular centers C1, C2, C3 respectively, we get that curve. Similar, let us assume now the curve is there. You want to determine that center point, reverse procedure. So same diameter, how much? 30, therefore radius the diameter 60, radius 30. So now reverse procedure, the given point on the curve that is considered as a center, intersect arc on that center. Clear? That's one. From here to here, center. We get this. So this size is 30. Previous one, for example, P3 means C3 as a center, intersect arc on that curve. But now reverse procedure from here to towards center. So this point. After that, all the lines are joining to O1. Similar case, this point also you join O1. Clear? So that line, where it is intersecting on that, directing here. Clear? So from that point, the line joining from here, this one. So this is for normal n dash. So tangent and normal is 90 degree to each other. So you draw a perpendicular line of n dash. So tangent and normals are right angles to each other. Clear? This is the case. Clear? That's all. Okay, students. So this is the procedure, how to construct a epicycloid and also how to draw a tangent and normal for a given dimension or anywhere on the curve means. Clear? So we go for in next videos in another special course. Clear? Thank you.